Thank you, Ethan. It was a robbery and sexual assault that turned into a standoff. This is video just into our newsroom of the man police say committed all of those crimes. He is in jail tonight.
It all started around 2 o'clock this afternoon when police say 19-year-old Jarvis Durr robbed a business at Hanging Moss Road. It ended when the SWAT team caught Durr inside a home right across the street. 16 WABT's Meg Pace has been on the story all afternoon. And Meg, this all started with that armed robbery.
Yes, Darren. Police say that Jarvis Durr robbed this business right behind me, Charms. He went inside, displayed a weapon, and then sexually assaulted one woman inside. Then he ran across the street, across Hanging Moss Road, and into this home where he barricaded himself. Now, about an hour later, around 3, the SWAT team busted into that home and pulled Durr out. This is a picture. When that happened, you can see a SWAT team member holding Durr's arms behind his back as he's being led out of the home. Police then spent about an hour and a half searching the home for any clues a suspect may have left behind. Now, an employee at a barber shop across the street from that home and next door to the business that was robbed says the suspect about 5 minutes before all this began, he came into their business and asked a couple of questions. And the employee told us about that. He didn't want to show us his face. He said he's a little nervous after he came face to face with the man police say committed those violent crimes this afternoon.
About 5-6 minutes, came running back across the street, holding his pants on one side, and ran into that White House over there.
Now, no one was inside the home when Durr barricaded himself in there, but the owners did come home shortly after the SWAT team pulled him out. Durr was taken to police headquarters. He's been charged with armed robbery of a business and rape, Darren.
Yeah, Meg, how is the victim doing tonight?
Well, we're speaking with one of the family members of the victim, and she tells us that victim is recovering tonight in a hospital. We're not going to share very many details about her just because we don't normally do that with sexual assault victims.
Totally understandable. All right, Meg Pace reporting live.